Hello, people. Chris Cobb with LightStomp here, and this will be the first of many tutorials I do for YouTube. Just going to kind of show you how to do the things that I have been able to figure out how to do while I'm developing. So I'm going to be using Blender 3.0, and I'm going to show you how to do a fluid simulation, and afterwards, how to add that into Unreal Engine 5 to use as a geometry cache, which is experimental, but it works quite well for me in 4.27 and 5 early access. So let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the default cube. I'm going to scale it up. Let's just say a scale of 4. I'm going to grab that and bring it to the floor. I'm going to hit Shift Z and go into wireframe mode. And I'm going to keep this simple. I'm just going to add in a UV sphere. Grab this and bring it somewhere around the top of the cube. We're going to use the sphere as our fluid. So we'll go over with the sphere selected and go to the Physics Properties tab, add a fluid, and make this flow. Change from flow type smoke to liquid, and change our flow behavior to inflow rather than geometry. The next thing we're going to do is create a fluid for our cube here, make this our domain, as this will be where the liquid flows into. So we'll change this domain type to liquid as well. And our resolution division, I'm gonna go ahead and change to 64, which is quite fast. So we can go ahead and hit the space bar, the play button in the animation timeline here. And as you can see, we can get a quick, simple simulation. And what I'm gonna do here, I'm not gonna get too advanced in this tutorial. So with our domain, our cube selected, I'm going to change from replay to modular for our type. And let's keep this at about 150 frames. So right about to here is where it'll stop simulating. We'll change the end frame to 150. And then we have seen the simulation working. So we can go ahead and hit bake data if we want to keep this at 64 with basically the same result. Okay, so we've baked the data, so we can play that back. And now that we have this data baked, we can move on to baking more data such as meshes, particles, and so on. And the up-res factor of 2, particle radius of 2.0. Everything we'll keep at default for now, just to give you a basic idea of how this works. Obviously, as you work up the numbers on these parameters, you're going to get higher resolution results and so on. Okay, in order for us to bake this mesh, we actually have to free the data that we just baked. And I actually should have checked this box here for is resumable from the get-go. So we've got modular and is resumable, and we can go ahead and bake that data again really fast. And now that we've done this correctly, we can bake the mesh. And once this is done baking, we can get out of wireframe mode and actually watch our mesh in action. Okay, so now that we've baked our data and baked our mesh, we can hit Shift Z to get out of wireframe mode, hit play. And there is our mesh liquid in action. Obviously not the highest resolution or anything of that nature. And as you can see, it continues until the end to put out more fluid. If you want to change this, just really quick, let's turn down the amount of frames that we're going to use here. I'm just going to do 100 frames, just so I could show you an example. You also need to change your frames here under the fluid settings. I'll just go back to wireframe mode momentarily here. Okay, so we're going to go to our sphere. Let's go back to frame 0 here so we see what we're doing a little better. And as you can see, we have an option here for use flow. And if you want to stop the flow of fluid after so many frames, it's fairly simple. The first thing I'm going to do is free our data. So once we do that, we no longer have the mesh baked or anything of that nature. So we'll go back to our sphere. Let's just go to frame 20, add a keyframe, and now we'll go to frame 21 and uncheck the use flow box and add a new keyframe. And as you can see, when we go from one keyframe to the other, the use flow is enabled and disabled. So what that should do now, when we go back and bake our data, is stop the production of flowing fluid after frame 20. And this should leave us a miraculous puddle. There we go. Forgive the horrible sound effects. Now we're going to bake our mesh again. Okay, we've baked our mesh. And as you can see, the flow stops after frame 20. And we have our animation that we're going to later use in Unreal Engine 5. So the first thing we need to do before we move on is have our cube selected. We don't need our sphere, our light, our camera. The data from the sphere is already baked to the cube, the domain. And we're going to export this as an Alembic file or a .abc geometry cache file. So for the sake of simplicity, let's just put this in a temp folder somewhere. Let's see, I have a 3D model temp. I will say 0_ABC. We have our frame start at 1, our frame end at 100, which is what we have here. And I am going to go ahead and remove the option to export hair or particles. And I'm going to keep the selection only to selected objects, which is our cube, our domain, with the data baked into it. And we will just name this simple liquid 01, whatever you'd like to name it. We will go ahead and export. And as you can see, it's exporting out each frame. And now we can navigate to our new folder with our new file and see it here. I'm going to go ahead and save the next part of this lesson for the next video, when we're going to actually import this into Unreal Engine, add a material to it, make it usable, and somewhat practical. Until next time, thank you for watching.